SABIS International Charter School in Springfield, Massachusetts. Tonight, we will be voting to elect our next president. While this may seem like a decision that only impacts us over the next few days, it means much more. Tonight, we will make a decision that will give a voice to the millions of Americans that have been silenced for too long. Tonight, we will choose leadership, compassion, and knowledge. When I think of what politics means to me, I don't see Democrats and Republicans. I see people, not labels. People that are all the same at our core. All of us came from a woman. That woman was not someone we chose. We did not choose her race, where she came from, whether she ate with her bare hands or a silver spoon. We did not choose her religion, sexual orientation, or even the language she spoke. We did not choose the lives we were born into. All of us have this in common and much more. While we did not choose what we were born into, we did choose to be here tonight. And by choosing to be here tonight, we are choosing to stand up for what we believe in and make our voices heard. As President Kennedy so eloquently put it, tonight we ask not what our country can do for us, but what we can do for our country. For generations, we have known that knowledge is power, yet we have never questioned the keeper of the keys. Our country was founded on the principle that all white, landowning, Anglo-Saxon, Protestant men were created equal. Now, we recognize that every man, woman, and child is equal, regardless of race, religion, sexual orientation, or any other man-made label that fails to define who we are. Too often, the government makes decisions to benefit one group of Americans. I promise to fight for what the rest of America needs. I will fight for immigration reform because no human is illegal. I will fight for common sense gun control because lives are worth more than money. I will fight for accessible health care and reproductive rights because health care is a human right. I will fight for an end to a cycle of poverty that fails on our promise for everyone to have a fair chance by raising minimum wage and giving schools the resources they need to educate. I will fight to end the death penalty that proves two wrongs do not make right. I will fight to end discrimination for people of color, women, and members of the LGBT community because we are all human. I will fight to end the injustices that do not provide people with the opportunities they deserve. We must be the change we wish to see in the world. Together we symbolize the potential for that change. With great power comes great responsibility. And I challenge everyone of you tonight to elect a leader that will stand up to the injustices of the current presidential administration. I am a double minority, and I will fight for not only equal opportunity, but every opportunity. Thank you for listening tonight, and I hope that you will choose the candidate for real change.